So Also with hippos, they don't typically swim on the top of the water. What they'll do instead is they just bounce along the ground underwater. So if you go, there's some to the left-hand side. Also on the left, those birds on the island are pink-backed pelicans. They don't look too pink when you first see them, but they do turn pink during mating season. And it's not their feathers, it's their skin that turns a pink color. It's almost like they're blushing. Really great view of this one kind of bobbing up and down, this hippo here, where they don't swim. They have a really neat mechanism in their brains as well. They can sleep in the water, underneath the water. That mechanism in their brain helps bob their pet, their bodies up and down to continue to get air without them even having to wake up to do so. We will be crossing this bridge up here to make sure everybody's still staying fully seated. Big reason why. On the left, those are Nile crocodiles. You can tell those are crocodiles, not alligators, because even with their mouths shut, they carry two fingers. Useful for animals because it holds a large amount of water, and during drought seasons animals can pierce the bark with their tusks or horns and helps give them water and whenever there's none in their home at the time. So because of that, it can also be called the tree of life. From up here we're overlooking the savanna, which can also be called the Serengeti dunes. So probably not very appealing to us, but they're very useful for other animals like giraffes, rhinos, and elephants. They basically use them as big backstraps because they can get as hard as concrete, so they make really great scratching cushions. And we baited up those zebras, and it looks like there's a couple little ones out there. One closest to us even. So these are mountain zebras. The way you know that immediately is that they don't have their stripes going across their bellies. They also have a skin flap that hangs from their neck that's called a dewlap. Those dewlaps help regulate their body temperature so they don't get too hot or too cold. And out of all the zebras, only mountain zebras have a dewlap. But other animals can. Other than the horns that the Ankuli cattle have, they have a dewlap as well. A group of zebras like this is called a dazzle, so you are looking at a dazzle of zebras. You can kind of see the wildebeest on the right hand side again. A better view of them. Here. everybody does know what a manta looks like, though, if you've seen Rafiki, because they are the same type of metal. Cheetahs are very fast animals. They can go up to about 75 miles per hour. Really cool thing about them is they are able to change their direction in mid-air or mid-sprint. They have a very flat tail that they utilize as a rudder. So while they are running at very high speeds or while they're in mid-air, all it takes for them to change their direction is to move their tail to the side they came from. We're going around a few kopi rocks just out to our left up here. Kopi rocks are utilized by a lot of different animals. They're really good outlet posts for animals to see their surroundings. Find dirt hugs. Really easy way to see one right now, but they're not. warthog to the left. They do have warts like they're being told to. They're just being padded spots on their faces. They also have two pairs of tufts that they create burrows with. You can see all the burrows throughout that area. So they create those burrows and then they back up into the burrows so that their tufts point outwards and have other forms of protection for themselves other than the warts. A few ostriches on the left-hand side. Ostriches have a 9-foot wingspan. That's just a foot less than the canopy above your heads right now. But sadly, they're a little too heavy to fly. So instead, they can run up to about 35 miles per hour. That's foster eggs on the ground. So those eggs might not seem too large from a distance, but a single one of them can equal to about 2 dozen chicken eggs. All three of those ostriches are females. If you were to see a male, they would have very rich, dark black colored feathers. Thank you.